Mohammad Choucair joins us from Archer Exploration to give us all an education on quantum computing and what Archer is up to with that. Nice to have you back.
I'm glad to be here.
So I suppose we should start with a definition, an explanation. What is quantum computing? What's quantum technology?
So quantum computing simply represents the next stage in computing and the next stage of advanced computing.
And what will it impact?
Well, it has the potential to impact across all sectors reliant on computational power, and that can include emerging sectors like artificial intelligence and big data, but also the financial sectors, cryptocurrencies, new currencies, and also in the pharmaceutical industries and new drug design and development.
I know there's a lot of people working on quantum issues around the world, especially here in Australia. What in particular have you been solving?
So I'm happy you mentioned that, because in Australia we do have a critical mass of experience in quantum technology and materials, which is fantastic. Quantum technology, it's a really diverse field, multidisciplinary, and a lot of different challenges that exist. When we talk about the materials challenges that exist, and of course with Archer this is our primary focus, the materials form a key component of the technologies, because the technology itself is tangible. And we need the materials for it to be tangible. We focus on the materials problem, and up until now, the materials that have been used to perform quantum computing either function at really low temperatures, or if they function at room temperatures, they're very difficult to integrate into modern electronics. So the solution that I came up with together with colleagues in the past at the University of Sydney was to combine the best aspects of those two fields. And we resulted in a material for the first time that could do the quantum processing at room temperature while being able to be integrated into modern electronics.
So Mohammad, you've touched on the value of R&D there. Can you tell me a bit more about how you're funding R&D, about how you're situated to take advantage of the global race in progressing quantum?
It's important to note that a few years ago, Australia was contributing about 5% of global spend on R&D in quantum computing. And together with North America and Europe, it was 70% of global spend on R&D. Yeah, it really emphasizes the high value in doing the R&D and leading the way and being the first mover. In order to capitalize on that R&D, you have to have the right people, the right infrastructure, and I think the right financial and legal instruments to navigate your way through a very complex stakeholder map. And you know, for us, executing on this, we are working towards having that license with the University of Sydney, an exclusive license, and that can form a really key instrument for us as we progress forward with our development work.
So Mohammad, of course these markets are emerging as you are developing these materials, this technology. Can you tell me about how you're going to capture market share? Tell us about the nature of the markets you're going after.
Well, I can tell you what we're not going to do. What we're not going to do is reinvent a business model or come up with something quirky and outrageous. So there are existing business models that have been successfully employed in the semiconductor industry, which is a very mature industry worth, you know, more than $500 billion of revenue a year. So the business model that is applied to the existing semiconductor industry, we can apply in the development of a specialty core componentry of the quantum computing architecture. And that would be into developing the quantum processor. And the quantum processor that we'll be developing is one that involves the carbon qubit processing. So this is what we're looking to do. And you know, traditionally, multinational companies that engage in this kind of business model, they sell directly to end users and customers, or they go through OEMs.
So Mohammad, obviously the markets that you're going to are developing at the same time as you're developing solutions for it. Can you tell me about the balance of innovating technologies and commercializing these technologies now and moving forwards for Archer?
Well, they go hand in hand. So the technical development, it helps and it underpins the market growth, and it goes hand in hand with our commercial development. Of course, with our commercial development, there's a whole bunch of facets to that, and our milestones quarterly. So we just look to hit those milestones, and we're looking forward to it and that negotiation with the University of Sydney coming through.
And tell me, what sets Archer apart in the quantum world with the work that you're doing and commercializing?
Well, first and foremost, the materials that we need to build the quantum processor are in our inventory. And what I mean by that is our wholly owned subsidiary Carbon Allotropes in the inventory of Carbon Allotropes, which is an online marketplace to sell carbon materials. We have the critical component which is able to process that qubit at room temperature. We also have the people, so I'm listed as a co-inventor on the patent that we're negotiating with the University of Sydney. And also just having that network and that growth to be able to access global networks that are in the know. So we're in a very critical early stage of the development of this technology, and the IP itself will allow us to progress forward and to develop the technology and have something tangible, and also to be able to enter markets in a very strong position in the future.
Sounds like exciting stuff, a massive breakthrough. What are you doing to commercialize this? What's the business model? How do you sell it?
Yeah, so in terms of the technology, it's really important that I can't overemphasize how important a technical development is. And this forms a very, very core part of the commercialization. And the reason why is because the market growth is dependent on advances in the technology development. All right, so reaching those technical milestones. And for us, that forms the key component there. And a lot of the work that we'll be doing involves realizing a technology that forms the basis of IP, intellectual property, that we look to license from the University of Sydney.
Very exciting stuff. So coming up, what are those big milestones, those big catalysts that you and your investors should be most aware of?
Yeah, so we're currently in negotiations with the University of Sydney for IP and a license for that IP, an exclusive license that could be applied in jurisdictions all around the world, including Australasia and North America and Europe. So it's quite exciting.
Yeah, remind us, what's that overarching vision for Archer Exploration?
So with Archer, we look to develop and integrate advanced materials in technologies in human health, reliable energy, and of course in the quantum fields.
And I know you want to dominate, so we'll be watching your progress very closely. Thanks for your time today, Mohammad.
No worries.